in the park, park. Cause she marks with an art, art. You coming at me like a knock, knock. You boy, I don't wanna start, start. Two words on my boat, I'ma start. I'm kinda like, you leaving this up with a mark, mark. I ain't got time for you, mark, mark.
Looking for a race when the sun goes down, then you're not a real racer.
Thank you. job for you.
Not until you give me something I can use.
I'm after the house's boss. The collector. He's bringing in more tech like they had on the Koenigsegg.
I'm listening.
You made Navarro's list. It's your chance to go undercover and find what you're looking for. Just keep your eyes peeled and your mouth shut. Congratulations, Miller. You work for the house now.
Today's payroll driver?
Mm-hmm.
Navarro said you didn't talk much.
Here's the payoffs and locations. I don't think you can run away with the money. I'm tracking you by GPS.
Where's the trust these days?
That'd be Silver Rock's top black market engineer. He specializes in bleeding-edge parts years ahead of anything street legal.
Whatever tech they're bringing in, the house racers are sure to have it soon. The donations for the orphanage in South Sudan are here, sir.
You have quite the mouth on you. What's your name?
My parents forgot to give me one.
High-ranking dignitary by day, street racer by night.
What's a foreign official doing taking bribes from the house?
He runs a drag racing league called the Diamond Block. Those were kickbacks for rigging races.
That's what you're after?
The seal of the stooge. I'm after his boss, the collector.
Thank you. I'm here to bribe some rich asshole, that you?
Where's the money, girl?
Don't girl me, asshole. Not bad so far. Who is that fine gentleman?
I see you met Hopeful. He's a contractor on a collector's big tower and the boss of an off-road racing league called Hazard Company.
Charming.
At least now you know what your crew is up against. Having second thoughts?
Hell no.
That's what I like to hear.
Talking. A little gratitude would be nice. Get out of my face.
You're impressing the right people, lady. Yeah, I got more work if you're interested. How's the getaway sound?
Right up my alley.
That's what I like to hear. Sending you the place.
Sunrise from behind the wheel.
Thank you.
garages. One in Silver Canyon and the others around Providence Mountain. What do you say? Time for a little splurge, am I right?
A useful part around here. I should check it out.
Thank you.
That's from a C10 Chevy pickup. Bet Mac would like that. him a thing or two. You and me, let's go.
First team in the NBA record-wise is giving it to the best team in the NBA record-wise. Ready to shoot, Jack. Still Dirk. A real actor. And the Mavericks are up 7. They were up double digits, but then here come the Celtics. The rookie.
Starkle wants to set up the screen. Flips it out to Williams.
Up on 3 to play Celtics down 6. Wild sequence here after Harrison Barnes took an ill-advised 3. Tatum saves it behind his back. Then Smart figures, why not? No. Again, another save. Right to the wrong guy if you're the Mavericks. Kyrie, and he buries the 3, and the lead's cut in half. The defense, meanwhile, on the other end for the Celtics was insane. Then they get a 3 from Smart. It's a 2-point game. Mavericks couldn't even get shots off. Kyrie takes that. Up top, Tatum doesn't really gather it, but it still ends up going in. The game's tied at 96. 6 seconds to go. Game tied. Barnes, Tatum with the defense. It rims out. Bodies hit the floor, and we head to overtime. More time benefits the better team, and the better team is wearing green. Kyrie off the Horford screen. Barea's down, and wide open shot gets buried. Now the Celtics up 2. It's Kyrie again on the way to 47 points as the Celtics win again. Kyrie afterwards on his offensive mindset.
The best answer for that is just called upon. Probably be the best answer. I don't think I needed to score over 20 or 25 in particular games, you know. So I think if you asked me that question probably a few years ago, I probably would tell you that, you know, I would definitely be trying to get 40, but it just happens. I don't really see it as a pressure situation. It's just like fun basketball, man. It's just like being in a park and, you know, 7-7 and game is in, you know, 8 and, you know.
Friday, saved big. You?
Actually, I got a solid 8 hours.
You snooze, you lose.
Still saved huge.
Get something you really want during the GMC Sierra Black Friday event. Get 20% below MSRP on specially equipped 2017 Sierra 1500 SLT Crew Cab models. That's over $11,200 on this GMC Sierra. We are professional grade. GMC.
This season, get two lines of unlimited data for $80 a month on the Cricket Unlimited 2 plan. Plus, get great deals on LG smartphones when you switch. All on a network that covers over 99% of Americans. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about.
What if your championship pedigree speaks volumes?
Anybody can lose to anybody on a week-to-week basis.
How do your wins stack up? What if you're flying under the radar?
Forget the metrics, just who's a better team?
What if everyone believes they can get in? What if your time is running out? The College Football Playoff Top 25 Ranking Show, Tuesday at 7 on ESPN, presented by Capital One.
Have you been canceled or refused because of too many accidents, traffic violations, poor credit, learner's permit, license suspension, or DWI? We can help. At Mazola Insurance, no one is refused.
You want more of that? We got you. Hundreds and hundreds of live games.
A gorgeous spin.
Get the full season.
All season long.
No sweat. Oh, you just want to watch your team. Guess what? We got you. Anytime, anywhere. It's that easy.
Call 844-807-2726 to order NBA League Pass today.
Have you been canceled or refused because of too many accidents, traffic violations, poor credit, learner's permit, license suspension, or DWI? We can help. At Mazola Insurance, no one is refused.
First Take, special edition Thanksgiving Day at 10 a.m. Eastern. Getting you set for a day of turkey and football. Enjoy. All right, a campus tour, all kinds of basketball all over the world. Gets confusing who's playing who. We'll try to get you dialed in here. Wichita State, number 6 in the land, and Cal is giving it to him. Justice Sui hits a 3, and he's fouled. Cal's up 18. They lost to Riverside. Greg Marshall's like, what are we doing? Well, what you're going to do is come back because you got Shaquille Morris, and you got a tough-minded veteran group. Here it's a 5-point game, and then 1, 2, and 3 the hard way. Suddenly it's a 2-point game, and you could see this coming a mile away. Not only is Wichita State win, but they win going away. Zach Brown there, the layup. Morris at 25-7. Wichita State wins by 10. They take on Marquette out in Maui. Creighton and UCLA. Mitchell Bolick of Creighton, freshman, fourth career game. He lives about 35 miles away from Kansas City where this game's going on. Here he misses, but gets the rebound, puts it in. They're up 5 at the break.
He's a freshman?
Freshman. Lefties always look perfect doing everything. Great baseball swings, great golf swings, and great strokes from deep. He was 7-14, had a career-high 22. Creighton had 5 scores in double figures. They win by 11. Marvin Bagley III, this guy's going to do a lot of rebounding and dunking and making anybody he faces look like they're not as good because they're not. Furman was on the wrong end tonight. Bagley went for 24-8 in 29 minutes. They win easily. Baylor will take on Creighton because they knocked off Wisconsin. Joe Luau Achiuwa there, the alley-oop. He had 19-10, and Baylor wins by 5 over Scotty. One final score to pass along from this weekend's action. I don't know how we didn't get to this on Sunday, but we didn't. The Newton Mustangs beat Fitchburg 44-12 to win the 7th grade Massachusetts State Football Championship. Shout out to Sam Johnson and his team. Okay, fellas, time to go to school now.
Well, hello, good people. Welcome in to another edition of NFL Primetime. I'm glad you are here with us.
Morstead puts it down. Lutz has it on its way, and the Saints win. An epic collapse by the Redskins and an epic comeback by the Saints results in their 8th straight victory.
And the ball came out. It's a fumble. The Eagles have picked it up, and they are running. Nigel Bradham down the right side, broke a tackle to the goal line. Touchdown, Eagles.
First of all, the message is basically, you know, we haven't done anything.
We definitely feel we're doing something special, without a doubt.
It's all ahead on NFL Primetime, and it starts now. everybody. Welcome into another edition of NFL Primetime. Glad you're here with us. Trey Wingo, Tim Hasselbeck, and Jeff Saturday. They did not tell me about the blue suit.
We did tell him. We told him.
I feel a little ostracized, I'm not going to lie. But that's fine. We'll move on. We're about to find out just how good the 2017 Rams are.
You're
their
correct.
First real test Sunday in Minnesota, that did not go well. Next up, an 8-game winning streak that the Saints will bring in. And here are all the teams that are floating around the top of the NFC. But let's go with the Rams, who just got waxed in the second half by Minnesota. Check out Case Keenum. I mean, dip. If you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
You know it's
basically what he just said. Avoids the sack. Of course he finds Adam Thielen. These two, first of all, Connor Barwood's got to be going, oh, he sees that film. Unbelievable, great play. Later on that drive, where's the L train? Latavius Murray.
All aboard.
Right up the gut, just like that. The Vikings tied it up at 7, and it just got better. Jared Goff for the Rams, looking for Cooper Kupp. Oh, the ball comes out at the 1. Big hit. Vikings, big stop, and it was all Minnesota after that. In the 3rd, still 7-7. Where's the L train? Look at that hole. My gosh, remember how bad this offensive line was a year ago?
Terrible. They are absolutely making plays. Like you said, he's not even slowing down when he gets through the line of scrimmage.
No, we're going that way, he said. Later on that drive, one more time. Right up the gut.
Got
in there.
That's awesome leg drive all the way around. He finished that run. That's what you want from an offensive line perspective. Watch them boys do their work.
95 yards, 2 tutties. Later in the 4th, Keenum feeling, 65 yards, and he is gone. 123 yards catching on 6 pass catches. Keenum, 280 passing yards, and the Vikings blow him out in the second half, 24-7. Now, the Rams blitzed a season-high 20 times, but Case ain't scared. 15-20 for a 191 against that blitz, including that 65-yard throw to Thielen that you just saw. You know, it's 5 touchdowns and no picks against the blitz at home this season without being sacked once. Tim, the way he's playing right now, you cannot look at Case Keenum and say he's a game manager. He is doing so much more than that.
I think what's sticking out right now is that he's creating offense for them. I mean, ultimately, I think when you look at, you know, guys that get labeled that, people are kind of attacking their physical skills. The truth is, we saw this in the highlight. He's making offense. It wasn't there. They have a deep crossing pattern called. Can't find it. Just the competitiveness in the pocket and the ability to find Thielen. I mean, he sees him. Thielen's running away from man coverage. You get it there. Here's the other aspect of his game that I think that hasn't gotten a ton of attention. He's a very good runner. It's man coverage. He sees that, and he takes off running. That's the 1st-and-10 play. You see the big game there. And so I think when you look at what Keenum's able to do, again, creating offense, they call a shot play, it's not there, he gets great pass protection. Just look at the confidence to remain a passer, stay in the pocket, and then find a tight end as he leaks out late. That right there shows you a quarterback it's not going too fast for him.
Right.
You know, he's not in a hurry to take off and start running when he doesn't need to be. And he also doesn't panic and feel like he just needs to throw it away. He's making stuff happen and also avoiding bad plays.
Well, not only that, but you saw when he tried to run and got the first down there, and he didn't slide, and Ogletree came up and hit him. He's able to go up and pat, like, hey, way to not slide. I mean, he's getting respect from the guys he's playing against as well as his teammates. So we always talk about the offense. This is what
always.
We do here.
Yes.
But those were two really good defenses that were on display Sunday, and the Vikings absolutely took it to Todd Gurley.
Yeah, listen, we talked about it. Gurley was the main thing you had to shut down right here. And let me show you all 3 levels of the Vikings defense. Right here, look right here. Harrison Smith, this is what you call setting the edge. Right arm free, left arm in the chest of Higbee. Watch him throw him back. Push it back into Linville Joseph. That is a physical play from a safety at the point of attack. Really well done for those guys. But it was every level. Like I'm going to show you on this next tape, whether it's linebacker, whether it's defensive line or safety, these guys are flat out getting after him. Right here, Griffin's going to go with Saffold. But look at Barr push Whitworth back in the backfield.
Yep.
Griffin has literally got Saffold on his knee, going to reach over him and make that tackle. That is, again, physical football. Now, right here.
I just caught right here.
Yeah. You want to know part of hair.
That was,
look
see
at
ya.
That. Boom!
Nothing for me today, thanks.
You are wrecking this human being at the point of attack. And again, that's a sat him down if Gurley's not behind him to help him stay up. But don't think about Harris. He made the strip on the 1-yard line.
Yep.
These are plays, but again, this physical defense, what they did to the number one offense, they kept them contained. Everything was compressed all day. No one got comfortable. It was really well done by that Vikings defense.
And now the Vikings head to Detroit for a Thursday Thanksgiving Day game against the Lions. Remember, they've The Vikings have already lost the game in Minnesota to Detroit, so this will be a critical game for both teams to see what happens. And again, as we said, the Rams go back home where they'll play the Saints, who have won 8 straight games. We'll get to that game a little later. Meanwhile, the Sunday night game, the showdown between the Cowboys and the Eagles, well, it wasn't a showdown because the home team didn't show. Third quarter, Eagles are down 9-7. Third and 8, Wentz fakes the handoff, rolls right. There's Brent Celek leaking out, and Brent Celek is wide open for the first down, a 28-yard completion. Sean Lee didn't play in this game for the Cowboys, and the Eagles exploited it time and time again. There's a nice strike to Alshon Jeffrey right over the middle. Again, they're in the red zone. Two plays later, Corey Clement. Where is the defense right up the middle? It's unbelievable. Eagles just going right at Dallas. They're up 15-9. Later in the third, same score. And it's a little throw here. Stack receivers.
The two-point play. It's a number count. You're either spitting it out or it's a quarterback draw.
Because Jake Elliott got hurt in this game. And there's Jay Ajayi.
Nice
Jay
play.
Ajayi. That was an alley.
Hey, if you don't get speed from Jones right there, that's to the house. But again, another great design. Little trap inside. You got so much penetration by those 3-and-1 techniques from Dallas. The Eagles just took advantage of it all night.
Yep, and then finds Torrey Smith on 3rd and 5 from the 11th. Flag on the defense obviously declined. Once again, they're going for two because Jake Elliott not there. Got hurt making a tackle. Gets away from
that's
David Irving. Gets away from... I mean, that's making something out of nothing. There's another flag. Don't worry about it.
Again, keeping the play alive is just incredible.
Okay, so we saw Jay Ajayi. We saw Corey Clement. Here comes LeGarrette Blount. They really have 4 guys that they can attack you with on the ground. It's really impressive.
And really the same play, offensive line scheme-wise, all of them are taking advantage of the same thing.
4th and 5. Can't kick a field goal, so we're going to do that instead. Throw a touchdown. Wentz, economical, 14-27, 168, and 2 touchdowns. But Wentz was perfect, 6-for-6 on 3rd and 4th down after the half, a major difference in the game. He threw 2 touchdowns on those downs while Dak turned it over thrice. Dallas lost a home game by at least 28 points for the 3rd time in the last 25 seasons. All 3 have come at the hands of Philadelphia. So, Jeff, there's a lot of problems right now for the Cowboys. It's not just about Tyron Smith and Zeke Elliott, because actually, Alfred Morse ran the ball okay. There are lots of problems on the Cowboys' offense.
Yeah, and it's happening in areas which you wouldn't expect it, right? We beat up on Bell and Green last week for Adrian Claiborne absolutely just terrorizing him. But the reality is, at more than just one place, they're struggling from an offensive line perspective. I'm going to show you exactly what I'm talking about. Now, Switzer opens a game with a big return, so they get the ball down. They throw it to Witten, so it's really 2nd and short. And what you're going to have is you're going to have Lael Collins and Martin on this double team, and they're going to go back here. And so as you're watching what they do, now again, this is 2nd and 3, watch Fletcher Cox right here as he gets off the line of scrimmage. Oh, bam, right? Now, you're about to watch. This is that's all pro. That's an all pro right tackle, right guard. Watch what happens to him. Fletcher Cox gets rid of him, meets Morris in the hole, finishes the play again. That's the strength of your football team, and they're showing up, and that's not helping. Now, we're going to go through the pass. We talked about Bell, who is right here, and how we can help him. So we're going to put our back and let him get back behind him and try to help. So you know Bell is going to block out, but here's your key. You have 2 guys over here. The guard's got one, and the back has the other. They have to do this, and they're going to do what they call a key screen. The Eagles are. They're going to watch this protection because they know they're going to try to help Bell, and here's what happens. Blitz comes. You see his eyes. He's looking to help. This young man right here, he's key blitzing on him blocking, so he's going to bring it, and he's going to bring it. Dak knows pressure's coming, so now Morse is going to have to step up, leave Bell on an island, and this is just nasty. Listen, Barnett, that's an absolutely incredible athletic play. You'll see another view of it, but he's literally running the hoop, and that means you're getting your body almost 90 degrees. Watch this bend.
Right there.
I mean, listen, Bell, I don't care how good you are.
Yeah.
That is a freak athletic play to reach, get your hand on Prescott's leg, and strip the ball for a touchdown. It was incredible, but again, it's more than just one guy. In areas that you expect them to be dominant, they are not dominant, and the Eagles' defensive line and linebackers took advantage of it all night.
By the way, that play by Derek Barnett, that's exactly how you get rid of Reggie White's name in the Tennessee record book for the most career sacks.
Yes, sir.
For the Volunteers, by moves like that. And whatever Jason Garrett said to the Cowboys at the half when they gave up that big play to Tyreek Hill, that was great. Since then, whatever you're saying, Jason Garrett, it ain't working. The last 2 games, the Cowboys have been outscored 47-0 after the half.
Just like yesterday, baby.
Hola. Me llamo Roberto.
Oh, we know your name. and we know your game. And the Raiders found out just all about that, too.
NFL Primetime is brought to you by Valerian and the City of a Thousand Planets. Available tomorrow on 4K Ultra HD and Blu-ray.
Focused. Roaming racer looks weak. Hope you don't have anywhere to be. We got a race.
Slipstream's the trickiest driver we have. Oh, you're going to have a hell of a time against him. Get ready. Get ready.
This is when I come alive.
I had homies in 11th grade doing gun trades. I got the dog. Okay. Shopped around like you're supposed to, but I always came back to the fort. It is a bit of and the least payment fits right into my budget. The aluminum body was a huge selling point, especially in our objective. Right? We love the truck too much.
Gentlemen, I go by the name of Ludacris. I'm here to break down so far from my favorite rapper. Right now, I'm gonna pay some homage to the one and only Pimp C. May he rest in peace, one of my favorite rappers of all time. It was a song from C. Murder, it was called "The Kick Up," and there were four bars that are very memorable to me. They are a part of my DNA, a part of my childhood. He said, "The game's fucked up, and I ain't got no friends. And I done spent my last $70,000 on the drop top beam. Cause I'm a trill nigga, down to put the 45 to his heel thing. The greatest four bars in rap ever. Why? Just because he meant every word that he said. When you get in this rap game, you start to lose friends. You have success, you start to get money. Money and friends is just very difficult to, you know, make business a pleasure. And then when he said, I spent my last $70,000 on a drop top bin, sometimes you want to live like tomorrow's not promised today. That's what he meant, cause I'm gonna shine. When he says trill, obviously UGK coined this term trill, which is true and real mixed together. And then he said, I'm down to put the 45 to his feet. A lot of rappers in the game talk a lot about shooting people with guns. If you want an individual that's really down to do it, really down to kill someone if he had to. So yeah, they were the trillest four bars of rap music. I got another one. From the song Woodwill, literally one of my favorite songs of all time. Pimp C started off the song by saying, I'm up early. My niggas don't sell dope after nighttime. Love chopping blades, rolling hoopies, moving dope through the pipeline. Pimp C, bitch, holla at your bitch, now your bitch on my team. Gotta find that sticky green, lace up with promethazine. Candy sweets, a candy bitch, you looking at a candy boy. I done came down Maine and Pop Trunk hit the switch on my candy toy. We all young ghetto boys, that's why we act this way. Trying to see $1 million, hoping these niggas don't blast. There's so many different meanings in that. So UGK, because, you know, we all doing certain drugs now. This is the cadences, the rhythm, the flow, everything. One of the best verses ever. 10 Crack Commandments by Notorious B.I.G. Big. I've been in this game for years. It made me an fall down, dog. No one's allowed. I'm copping everything. I'm done with browse. It's the top don glockpalm.com. Get your shit rock mine like I seen rock mine. And I'm extra scary. CEOs all the front and ain't necessary. I fuck they secretary. All for information. It ain't necessary. They in love like the 14th of February. Play them like April 1st, right before I slide off. It could be March 2nd, sound like July 4th. How do you start off a verse and rap better than that? I'm gonna start a real scene. I fucking love it. I fucking love this verse. He's just basically saying, cash first, women. It's so many.
Says he's gonna save us all. What a hero. Show him how we treat heroes.
Damn, Gaia, what happened to you?
Oh,
There we go. This isn't what I had in mind.
Guy says he's gonna save us all. What a hero. Show him how we treat heroes.
Damn, Gaia, what happened to you?
gotta keep it up.
Guy says he's gonna save us all. What a hero. Show him how we treat heroes.
Damn, Gaia, what happened to you? Sorry, I had to.
bullshit.
Guy says he's gonna save us all. What a hero. Show him how we treat heroes.
Damn, Gaia, what happened to you? Forget it. Keep going.
No, what the fuck, man? God, get me!
Guy says he's gonna save us all. What a hero. Show him. them how we treat heroes.
Damn, Gaio, what happened to you?